Hello everyone, how are you today? Today it's lesson 37, unit Life's Great Events. Well, in life there are many great life events. Well, what kind of great life events can you think of? Well, in this unit, on page 90, we will talk about marriage. Well, it's one of the greatest events in your life, right? Well, here on page 90, there's test your grammar section. Well, here, the grammar points we will look at in this unit is reported speech. Reported speech라고 하면 어떻게 누가 말을 했을 때 그 말한 것을 이렇게 대신 걔가 그랬대 이렇게라고 말했대 이런 식으로 말하는 거죠. 즉 화법이 되는 거죠. 한국말로 하자면 화법 중에서 뭐 간접화법, 그다음에 직접화법 이런 것들 기억나시죠? 간접화법이라고 하면 it's reported speech, so it's not that the person directly talks, but you kind of reports. 대신 와서 이제 전해주는 거고, 그다음에 direct speech 하면은 그 따옴표 그대로 끌고 와서 곧장 쓰는 것들을 말하는 거죠. 자, on page 90, there is a picture here. This couple, well, Joel and Tara. Well, first we will listen to reported speech. 그 간접화법으로 먼저 이 상황을 들어보고요. 그 다음에 그 간접화법에서 we will pull out the original sentences what each person says. Okay? So first, let's look at the picture and listen to the reported speech. Joel greeted Tara and asked how she was. She told him she was fine. He said it was great to see her again. She said they hadn't seen each other for a while. Joel said there was something he wanted to ask her. He told Tara that he loved her and asked if she would marry him. She said that she would and that she loved him too. Okay, so how was it? 너무 그런 거 아니에요? 자, 일단은요, it makes me feel jealous. 이렇게 막 무릎 꿇고 앉아가지고서 the guy is bending like on his knee like 이렇게 막 이건 뭡니까? 이거 반지도 있다만 하고 눈알보다 더 커요 보니까 에잇! Anyway, so let's pull out the original sentences what they might have said, okay? 그 처음에 reported speech 보면은 뭐 Joel이 Tara를 만났습니다 그래서 인사를 했다 이런 얘기가 나오죠 Joel greeted, like greet 하면은 뭐 인사하다. Greet that means say hello, right? So here, Joel and Tara's lines here. The first, Joel says, hi Tara. Well, this is the part where Joel greeted Tara, right? So, hi Tara, this part. And he asked how she was. And then you should ask, like just directly, how are you? Right? Reported speech에서 direct speech 이렇게 왔다리 갔다리 할 때요. 보통 똑같은 거를 가긴 가되 one tense back 뒤로 가야 되죠. 그러니까 여기서 과거로 뭐뭐라고 물었습니다 라고 하면 그 안에 있는 것도 one tense back 밀어줘야 되는 거죠. 그래서 one tense back rule. Well, you gotta remember that. So, how she was? 그러면 여기서는 아까는 reported speech였으니까 one tense back 했고 여기서는 다시 it's direct speech. So, one tense forward. 앞으로 빼줘야 되는 거죠. 그러면 how? 이렇게 되겠죠. 이제 만나서 잘 있었냐? 인사를 하게 됐네요. And Tara says, well, in reported speech, she told him she was fine. Then, in this case, oh, I'm fine. Thanks. 뭐, 이건 뭐, okay, between couples, I don't think they just say like this. It's quite official. Like, how are you today? Like, oh, I'm fine. Well, normally, people don't say this way, but, in order to present direct speech and reported speech, this book presents this dialogue, okay? Okay, then next, Joel says, it's great to see you. 그맨 처음에는 그 he said it was great to see her 이렇게 됐지만 이쪽에서 a direct speech인 경우에는 it's great to see you again 이렇게 되겠죠? It's great to see you again. 다시 만나서 반갑다. 뭐 이렇게 되겠죠? Okay, next one. Tara, Tara said you too. That means it's great to see you again too. Like, it's great. Well, from your part, you said it's great to see me. Then my part, like, yes, it's great to see you too. Okay? And the next. Here, we seen each other for a while. Well, in reported speech, they said, like she said, they hadn't seen each other. She said they had not seen. 과거고, 여긴 과거 완료로 썼죠. 말했다, 우리 한동안 보지 못했다고. 그럼 여기서는 또 앞으로 하나 빼서 이거는 현재 완료로 쓰면 되겠죠? 이때까지 우리 계속 못 봐왔었구나. 이렇게, 그렇게 가야 되겠죠? 그러면 we haven't seen each other for a while. 그러니까 한동안 우리가 못 보았다. We haven't seen each other for a while. And then Joel says, oh, yes. Well, he agrees to her. Yes, you know. And here, there, something I. Well, in reported speech, well, Joel said there was something that he wanted to ask her. 과거, 과거로 갔죠? Then one tense forward, 현재로 가야 되겠죠? There's something I want to ask you. 알겠죠? In reported speech, after this, he said like he loved her. 사랑한다 라고 말했다. 사랑한다. And then I love you. 이렇게 되겠죠? And then after that, I love you. And then what question he asked? Well, actually, he popped the question. Pop the question 하면요. Propose. Well, usually people say propose. Like 결혼해달라고 이제 프로포즈 하다. 예, propose죠. 그다음에 또 propose의 another expression for that is pop the question. 그 질문을 pop 하면 이렇게 팍 이렇게 떠올리는 거잖아요. 그러니까 시지와! 이렇게, 이렇게 말하는 것을 pop the question 한다고 하죠. So he just popped the question. And I love you and 나랑 결혼해 줄래요? 이런 얘기죠. Will you marry me? 아, marry는 타동사니까 me가 곧장 나오는 거죠. Marry with me? 이렇게 안 하죠. 아, will you marry me? And Tara said, oh yes. 이렇게 당장 말해도 되는 겁니까? 네? 그냥 좀 생일 좀 해볼게 뭐 이래야지 너무 oh yes right away anyway so it's none of my business anyway but still oh yes yes I will 그래 결혼하겠다 and then after that I love you too 나도 사랑해 뭐 이런 oh 세상에 뭐 이런 lives well yeah this is really great lives events but it's a bit cheesy Well, do you know cheesy? Cheesy에서 나온 거죠. Cheesy, like, oh, 좀 cheesy해. 좀 cheesy했어요. Oh, 세상에, 정말 샘나라. Okay, next. Okay, okay. I gotta wake up. Sorry. And so we just checked reported speech and direct speech. We just kind of like listened to that reported speech of this, and then we just elicited the original sentences. Okay? Now, let's move on. The wedding on page 90. Well, reported statements and questions here. Number one, here, Elliot and Martha are guests at Joel and Tara's wedding in Atlanta. Well, so the background, the setting is Atlanta in America. And the couple is like Tara and Joel. Well, these people are getting married. So, it's their wedding. And here, Elliot, Martha, they are just guests at the wedding, okay? And I want you to remember that Martha and Ron, they are husband and wife. And Elliot is just some other guy, okay? Martha, Ron, they're a couple, they're a husband and wife. And Elliot is some another guest at the wedding, okay? Well, now we will listen to Martha talking about what happened. Well, actually, she somehow met this guy, Elliot, like another guest at this wedding, and they talked. And Martha told her husband, Ron, what happened. Like, 이 사람 만났는데, 내가 엘리엇이라는 사람 만났는데, 이 사람이 이랬대, 저랬대, 저랬대. 라고 Ron한테 지금 말을 해주는. 즉, reported speech가 되겠어요. So, before we solve this question number one, let's listen to the reported speech from Martha's part, okay? Let's check that too.
I just met this really nice guy named Elliot.
Oh, yeah?
He was very friendly. Do you know what he said? First, he asked me how I knew Joel and Tara. I told him that I had studied with Tara at UCLA. Then he asked if I was married. Of course, I said that I was.
He asked you that?
And next, he asked where we'd met. I told him that we'd actually met at a wedding.
You told him that?
Sure. Then he wanted to know how long we had been in Atlanta.
Really?
I said we had just gotten here yesterday, that we had flown in from Orlando.
Uh-huh.
He asked if we lived in Orlando, so I told him that we did.
What else did this guy want to know?
Well, he asked where we were staying in Atlanta, and it turns out that he's staying at the Four Seasons, too.
I see.
Then he asked if I could meet him later for coffee.
Mm-hmm.
I said we could, and that I would introduce him to you.
I'm not sure I want to meet this guy.
Okay, so this was like Martha and Ron's conversation. And Martha met this guy named Elliot. Elliot이란 이름의 남자를 만났다. 맨 처음에, in the beginning of this conversation, she said, Oh, I've just met a really nice guy named Elliot. Elliot이라는 진짜 괜찮은 남자 만났어. 이렇게 말을 했죠. 아, 그때부터 이제 좀 이 husband, Ron은 그래? Really nice guy라고? 약간 이런 느낌이 들겠죠? 아 그러면서 이제 그 남자 나한테 이런 걸 물었다. 뭐 How do you know them? Like Joel and Tara. 그리고 뭐 결혼했냐? 뭐 이런 거 물었다. 그래서 나는 뭐 이렇게 말했어. 그러니까 이제 남편은 Oh yeah? 이렇게 계속 이제 말을 하죠. 그래? Really? 뭐 이런 식으로 계속 그냥 시큰둥하게 말을 하고 있죠. 그래서 뭐 그 사람 어디서 왔대, 뭐 어디서 지낸대더라. 우리도 여기서 지낸다고 하니까 만나지. 이렇게 얘기를 했다. 그러니까 at the end of the conversation, the husband said, I'm not sure I want to meet this guy. 지금 만나고 싶은 것 같지 않다. 즉, 안 만나고 싶다는 얘기죠. 그냥 만나기 싫어. I don't want to meet this guy. Then it's quite strong. So it's a bit less strong than that. Just I'm not sure I want to meet this guy. 만나고 싶지 않은데? 좀 이상한 것 같은데? 뭐 이런 느낌이 오는 거죠. 자, 그러면은 이렇게 we just listened to reported speech of Martha's part. And then, like we just did in Joel and Tara's conversation situation, like in that case, we listened to reported speech first, and then after that, we pulled out the original sentences they said. 그러니까 reported speech, 그 간접 합법으로 된 거 듣고 그 다음에 직접 합법으로 고쳤잖아요. 이번에는 요 엘리엇이라는 사람 만나서 뭐 어쩌고저쩌고 했대라고 하면서 그 사람이 나한테 물었는데 어쩌고저쩌고 라면서 론한테 간접 합법으로 얘기를 했잖아요, 지금. 그러면 요 시츄에이션에서 그 들은 것을 바탕으로 해서 이 마르사하고 엘리엇이 원래는 어떤 얘기가 오갔을까? 그 오리지널 센텐스. 들을 한번 찾아보도록 하겠어요. 자, 그러면 page 90. Number one, there are two columns, right? So, here Elliot's questions are like here like seven questions. Well, first we got to listen to Elliot's first sentence, like first question.
How do you know Joel and Tara?
Okay, so the question was, how do you know Joel and Tara? Well, 어떻게 아느냐? How did you meet them? Like this, right? And Martha says, well, of course, she should answer this question. Then here, well, in Martha's answer, there should be some kind of clue how they are related to each other. Well, in Martha's column here, B, the fourth sentence, well, she said, I studied at UCLA with Tara. So Tara And Martha, like Tara is a bride. Tara가 결혼한 사람이죠. 그리고 Martha는 친구. So Tara and Martha were friends from university. 대학 친구가 되겠네요. And she knows Tara this way. And Joel's case, Joel is Tara's boyfriend. So that's how she knows them together. Okay? So how do you know Joel and Tara? I studied at UCLA with Tara, like this. Okay, then second question. Let's listen to second question of Elliot.
Are you married?
Okay, Elliot just asked, are you married? 결혼하셨어요? Yes, right away. Just right after, like, how do you know them? And then, are you married? Well, he's very interested in this woman, Martha. Well, actually, in Korean culture, people just ask around, are you married? Do you have a boyfriend or girlfriend? Well, people think it's not impolite. 루드하다고 생각하지 않죠? 그냥 궁금해서 이렇게 물어본다. 당신이 나에게 관심이 없으면 왜 그게 궁금합니까? 이렇게 되죠. 그 in Western culture, only if you are interested in that person, you ask them, like, are you married? Do you have a boyfriend or girlfriend? Like, 나 어떠냐? 이제 이런 말과 똑같은 얘기가 되는 거죠. 나랑 한번 잘해봅시다. 없으면. 이렇게 되는데, this person just asked this question right away. So, we can tell, Elliot is hitting on her. Like, hit on 하면, well, I think I already let you know this expression before. Hit on 하면, 작업하다였죠? 아, 한국말로도 좀 웃긴데. Hit on, 누구한테 막 이렇게 축축, 찝쩍댄다. 뭐 찝쩍쇠, 껄떡쇠 하면서 얘기했던 것 같은데요. So, 껄떡쇠. He's hitting on her by asking, are you married? Like this. So, if Elliot said, are you married? Then Martha should say yes or no. Because are you married is yes no question. So, the answer should start with yes or no. Well, in this column, the sentences starting with yes or no are the first one, yes, we do. Well, here, but we do. Are you married? 아로 시작했는데, 두로 끝났으니까, this one is not the right one. And then another yes is in the middle. Yes, I am. And more information at the end. That's my husband over there. So here, husband, well, that's related to like getting married. So this one is the right answer. So he asks, are you married? Oh, yes, I am. And that's my husband over there. Okay, so, well, she already told him, yeah, I'm married. I'm not available. 꿈도 꾸지 마라. 나 이미 임자 있어. 이렇게 말을 한 거죠. 저기 허즈번드도 저기 있다. 저거 봐. 저기 있어. 이렇게 되는 거죠. Okay, next, let's listen to the third question Elliot asked.
Where did you meet your husband?
그 다음 question, it's a bit more weird. 점점 더 이상해집니다. 자, 결혼했냐? Over there, there's my husband. Then, that should be period. Period means 끝. 그죠? 원래 period 하면 마침표잖아요. 또는 기간. 또는 마침표. 그래서 마침표의 뜻으로서 끝. That's the end of the story. That's period. So it should be period there. But this guy doesn't give up. 포기하지 않습니다. 다시 물어보죠. Where did you meet your husband? 어디서 만나셨어요? 이제 좀 어떤 틈새를 보고자. Where did you meet your husband? Then Martha should give the information about where she met her current husband. Well, here, this one, well, scan, and the second sentence from the bottom. Actually, I met him. 어디서 만났냐를 물어봤으니까 어디서 만났다. Met, 뭐 이런 단어가 들어가야 되죠. I met him at a wedding. 결혼식에서 만났다. I guess they met someone else's wedding. So they went there as guests, and then they saw each other, and they fell in love. Okay, and next, the fourth question Elliot asked. Let's listen to that.
Have you traveled far to get here?
Okay, so here, this time, how far? Well, here, Martha and her husband, Ron, they came here to attend their wedding, like Tara and Joel. 그 웨딩 참석하려고 온 거잖아요. 그래서 얼마나 멀리 왔었냐? Where are you from? 과 똑같은 얘기나 마찬가지죠. 얼마나 오래 걸려서 여기 왔느냐? 어디서 왔느냐? 이런 얘기죠. Have you traveled far to get here? 여기 오기까지 이렇게 물어보고 있어요. Then Martha says, because the question started with have you traveled? Like have PP. 그렇죠? 그러면 the sentence should start with like have PP. Like yes, I have or no, I haven't. 이런 식으로 가야 되죠. The answer with have or haven't is the last one. No, we haven't. No, we haven't traveled far. Well, it's quite close. 이런 얘기죠. We just got here yesterday. We flew in from Orlando. We flew in. 들어왔다. We came here from Orlando. Okay, now the next question. Let's listen to it.
Do you live in Orlando?
Okay, because Martha just said, oh, we flew in here from Orlando, so he asked more about it. Like, Orlando? You're from Orlando, so do you live there? Like that. And then Martha says, well, because it's yes, no question, right? Do you live? Then yes or no. The question should start with yes or no. So yes, no question, yes, no answer here. The only answer left with yes or no is the first one in Martha's blank, Martha's chart. The first one, yes, we do. Well, yes, we live in Orlando. Me and my husband live there, right? Okay, now, next one.
So, where are you staying in Atlanta?
Okay, so, he said, so, that means like, 그래서? Well, it's more like he kind of wants to change the topic. Change topic 할 때, 근데, 뭐, 그나저나, 뭐, 이런 얘기죠. 뭐, 꼭 그것이, 뭐, 뭐, consequence에 따라서 so를 쓰는 것이 아니고, 그냥, 좀 근데 하면서, change the topic. So, where are you staying in Atlanta? And actually, the way he spoke was a bit sleazy. Well, sleazy means like, well, this person is kind of like trying to hit on her. 어떻게 좀 해볼까? 목소리 자체가 좀 이상하지 않았어요? Sleazy 했었죠? Like, 어디서 묵으세요? 뭐 이런 식으로 약간 좀 느끼한 듯한 느낌을 받으셨죠? Where are you staying in Atlanta? Because the setting here, the wedding, the Tara and Joel's wedding is at Atlanta here. So Atlanta 여기서 어디에 지내시나요? 이렇게 물어본 거죠. And Martha says, then Martha gives the answer like, we are staying somewhere, like such and such place. And here, the third sentence, we are staying at the Four Seasons Hotel. Well, she gave out the name of the place where they are staying now. It's a bit dangerous. Okay, and next question. Let's listen to that.
So am I. Can we meet there later for coffee?
Oh, it was a bit scary now. It's even scary. So am I. Oh, that's good. I am staying there too. Like, he's a bit very, you know, trying really hard here. So can we meet there later for coffee? 커피 마시러 나중에 좀 만나실 수 있을까요? 이렇게 물어보는 거죠. Well, but somehow Martha is very naive. I don't know. Well, maybe she doesn't know what's going on. Maybe. So Martha says here, the last one left in this chart is the second one. Oh, sure. She just accepted it. Like, okay, good. Sure. And then she said, I will introduce you to my husband. She's just being naive, like, okay, well, we can have coffee there. I will bring my husband. 뭐, 허즈번드도 소개시켜 드리죠, 뭐. 이렇게 되는 거죠. Okay, so we just checked Elliot's and Martha's questions and responses all together. Okay, now, well, let's move on to the next page, page 91. 지금까지 이제 Elliot and Martha가 이렇게 말한 것까지 다나나나 이제 꺼집어 봤죠? 그러면 page 91, the practice section, number 3, this small title is like, he's a liar. Well, liar is a person who lies, right? Well, we should check out this together and let's find out who is a liar here. 누가 거짓말쟁이인지 한번 알아볼게요. Number 3 says, Martha and Ron are talking about Elliot. Complete Martha's lines in the conversation. So after the Martha and Elliot's conversation, now she came back to Ron and told him what happened. 뭐 이런 일이 있었어라고 이제 말을 하면서 서로 이제 얘기를 하는 거죠. 자, number one 보도록 할게요. Number one, well, R means Ron, husband. M is Martha, wife. Okay, R. Elliot lives in Detroit. And Martha says, but he told me he blank. And in parentheses, there's New York. Well, that means Elliot told Martha that he's living in New York. 그러니까 Ron에게 말하기로는 엘리엇은 디트로이트에 산다고 했다. 그래서 Ron이 그 사람 디트로이트 산대. He lives in Detroit. And Martha said, really? But he told me that he lives in New York. 나한테 뉴욕 산다고 했는데? 이렇게 되는 거죠. 그러면 but he told me 그 다음에 들어갈 것은 1번 같은 경우에 he가 앞에 써 있으니까 I will just omit it. He 여기서 he lived in New York 이렇게 되겠죠? 이렇게 되죠? He lived in New York. Well, Ron says he lives in Detroit. Present tense. 지금 디트로이트에 산대 이렇게 되는 거죠. Lives. 그런데 Martha의 케이스에는 나한테 어디 산다고 말했어 이렇게 되니까 he told me. 그러면 여기서도 he lives in New York 이렇게 안 하고 lives보다 one tense back. Because here told it's 과거 시제죠. 과거 시제니까 하나 뒤로 빼야겠죠. 그러니까 he lives가 아니고 instead of lives, you should say he lived in New York. 이렇게 가야 되겠죠. Okay, the second one. Ron says he doesn't like his new job. He doesn't like his new job. And Martha says, but he said that. 여기서도 또 한 번 said, 뭐뭐 말했어 라고 말했으니까 one tense back. Word, right? One tense backward. 과거형으로 가지겠죠? But he said that he blank it. And the word in parentheses given to us is love. And then the tense is changed. So we should write loved. So to Ron, well, Elliot said he doesn't like his new job. Well, Elliot kind of hates his job. But to Martha, he said, oh, I love my job, like this. So he lied. Okay, number three. And Ron says, well, oh, he's moving to Iowa. Well, Elliot is moving there. Elliot이 아이오와로 간대, 갈 거래, 이렇게 말하는 거죠. But Martha says, huh? Really? But he told me something different. But he told me blank and Florida here. 아, 아이오와 말고 플로리다라고 간다고 그랬었는데 이렇게 돼야 되죠. Then one tense back again here. So he's moving? No, he was moving to Florida. 이렇게 가야 되겠죠. Well, actually, Iowa is a bit boring, a lot more boring than Florida. Florida, people think of Florida is really luxurious and it's really good resort. And many people go there to retire and it's a very expensive area. So this guy said, Florida 간다. 이렇게 얘기를 하는 거죠. 그러니까, 근데 사실은 그냥 아이오와, 그냥 just normal 한 곳으로 가면서 말로는 플로리다로 갑니다. 이렇게. He kind of exaggerated. Well, it's not even exaggeration. It's a lie, right? 거짓말 뻥치는 거죠. 플로리다로 간다고 했다. 마르사가 계속 just in the middle of this conversation between Ron and Martha, Martha is like figuring out like what kind of lies he had told her. 어떤 거짓말 했는지 지금 계속 알아내고 있는 거죠. Okay, number four. Ron says he stayed home on his last vacation. So, on last vacation, he just stayed at home. He didn't do anything special. But to Martha, he said something different. Martha said, oh, but he told me blank. And the word in parentheses, Paris. He was just staying at home. But to this woman, I was in Paris. 파리 좀 갔었습니다. 이렇게 얘기를 하는 거죠. 집이 방콕하고 있었던 주제에! 그런 거죠. 자, 그러면 Martha was surprised. Ah, really? But he told me that he went to Paris. 이렇게 되는 거죠. 오케이. Okay, next one. Like Paris, 좀 더 좋은, 집에 있는 것보다 훨씬 좋고. And usually people have this kind of fantasy toward Paris. Paris에 대해서 환상을 많이 가지고 있어요. 특히 프랑스에 대해서 Paris, 아름다운 도시고, romantic 이렇게 생각하거든요. Okay, number five. Ron says he will be 40 next week. Well, his age. So he's gonna be 40 years old next week. And Martha, once again, gets surprised. She said, but he told me blank. And then and the word given here is 30. Well, actually, his real age is kind of 40. But he lied about his age and said, I am 30. 10 years difference? 이건 너무 했죠. 자, but he told me he 자, will의 과거형 한 one tense back으로 가야 되죠. Will의 과거형은 would가 되는 거죠. 그러면 he would or just he'd like thus. He'd become, he'd be 30. But he told me that he was going to be 30 next week. And then the truth is, no, 40. Like, ooh, surprising. And next one, number six, Ron says he's been married 3 times. He's, that means he has been married. So it's about his life experience. In his life, he has been married 3 times. 결혼 세 번 해봤다, 이런 얘기인 거죠. And then Martha says, but he told me blank and the words given here, never slash married. So he lied. He said he has never been married. 결혼 한 번도 안 해본다. 저는 결혼 한 번도 안 해봤어요. 그런데 알고 보니 세 번을 했다는 거죠. 자, 그러면요, 여기서 well, he's been married, has been 이렇게 현재, present tense로 갔죠. 그렇지만, but he told me, told, it's past, right? So, in this case, we should make it like 과거, 완료 시제로 가야겠죠? 그러니까 위에는 현재 완료로 갔잖아요. 그러면 여기서는 one tense back 하면 과거. 그러면 여기는 과거 완료로 가야 되는 거죠. 과거 완료. 그러면요, he had been 이렇게 가는 게 과거 완료잖아요. 그런데 한 번도 안 해봤다. had never been으로 가야 되겠죠? 그런데 이제 줄여서 he'd, he had. 이렇게 되겠죠. So Martha says, once again, she got really shocked, I guess, this time. But he told me he had never been married. And Ron says, you see? See, I told you. I told you he was a liar. 내가 말했지, 거짓말쟁이라니까 걔 이상해. 이런 얘기죠. But I think he's not a liar. In this case, how could you just call him just a liar? It is a fraud. No, fraud 아시죠? Fraud is someone who tells lies a lot, but sometimes it's like dishonest or even illegal ways. 그러니까 사기꾼인 거죠. 사기꾼, fraud. Well, I guess he's a fraud. It's not a liar. It's more than that. 이렇게 많은 거짓말을 막 하면서 거의 뭐 사기꾼 수준인데요. Okay, so we just checked number three from number one to number six. We just filled in these blanks with proper words. Okay, this time let's listen to this conversation together. Okay.
Elliot lives in Detroit.
But he told me he lived in New York.
He doesn't like his new job.
But he said that he loved it.
He's moving to Iowa.
But he told me he was moving to Florida.
He stayed home on his last vacation.
But he told me he went to Paris.
He'll be 40 next week.
But he told me he'd be 30.
He's been married 3 times.
But he told me he'd never been married.
You see, I told you he was a liar.
Okay, so we just checked this conversation too. Well, today we studied reported speech and direct speech. And, well, the one thing you should remember is when you make some sentences like direct speech and reported speech, the thing is you should remember that the tense should be different. One tense back rule. 그러니까 direct speech에서 reported speech 갈 때 뭐뭐 했었어, 걔가 뭐라고 말했어 라고 말할 때에는 한 시제 뒤로 백해서 과거로. 과거로 말했으니까 그 말한 사실은 더 과거로 가야 된다. 이제 이것만 기억해 주시면 되겠어요. Okay, then I will wrap it up and have a good day and see you next time. Okay, bye bye.